Hi, so today I'm going to do a piercing and tattoo update video. I haven't had many more piercings since the last time that I did an update video, but I do now have 4 tattoos. So someone asked me to do this, so I'm going to do it. So first we'll start with piercings. Altogether I have 14. So we'll start with my ears. My lobes are stretched to 40mm, so that's those. And then I've got a second piercing and my conch on this side. And on the other side, I have my 14mm stretch lobe. And my second and up here is my helix. So those are my ears. I don't have too many ear piercings maybe because like my conch and my helix were absolutely horrific to heal. And it's really uncomfortable when I go to bed and stuff. I have to like sleep in certain positions so I don't knock, especially the helix. So yeah, now next is facial piercings. I've got a mirror behind so I can see what I'm doing. I have this nose ring here. I usually have a nose stud here, but I've lost them all and I need to order some more, so I have one here. My septum, which looks like that. This is like a new thing. Usually I wear a clicker in it, but I decided to mix it up a bit. And then my Medusa, which is that one, my labret, which is this one, and then my 2 tongue piercings. I've had the front one done for quite a while. The back one's a new piercing. The back one is being held really, so yeah, I wouldn't recommend it. I don't know if it's just my mouth or whatever, but the healing process has been a bitch and I keep catching it on things and it keeps like ripping or getting infected and stuff like that, but yeah. That's those. And then I've got my belly pierce as well, but I'm not going to show that. You'll probably see it when I show my tattoo. Okay, so now for tattoos. The first one that I'm going to show you, and the first one that I got, was the tattoo on my ribs. Now, I've already made a video of this. It's like my first tattoo or something on YouTube. So I'm not going to go into too much detail. I'll probably link the video below for an explanation for that, because I don't really want to go into it again. So I'll just show you it and not explain it and I'll link the video. So this is the first one. So fall in love with tragedy. Across my ribs. So the next tattoo that I got after that was an origami pig on my arm. So I'll show you that now. It's on the inside of my arm. I got this tattoo because I want tattoos to represent like people that are influential in my life. So eventually I'll get one to represent like grandparents and mum and dad and stuff like that. But this is for my granddad. I absolutely love pigs to start with, so I probably would have gotten it anyway. But the main reason behind it is that when we were little, my granddad used to tell us stories about pigs, because he used to work with pigs when he was younger, and there's pigs all over his house, so whenever I think of my granddad, like, pigs are always involved some way. I didn't want like a pink pig just slapped on my arm, so I got an origami one instead, because it's a bit more kind of feminine and stuff like that. The next one is on the other inside of my arm, and it's a pair of scissors, and it looks like this. So yeah, this has a double meaning. So first of all, the kind of obvious thing is that I'm going to do fashion at uni in September. I've always been in art and fashion and design and textiles and stuff like that, so that's like one of the reasons that I got it. Another reason, I absolutely adore like Victorian scissors and stuff like that, so it's nice to have it on my arm. And it covers a lot of my, well, it goes over the place where I used to self-harm, so kind of scissors cutting, like, you'll get the gist. So it's not, self-harm is something that I don't like want to kind of box up and forget about. So it, yeah, it's to do with that. And the final one is a death's head hawk moth, just under my bust. This was the most painful one. I kind of tapped out halfway through. I cried. So I'll show you that now. So it's like just under my bust, just there. almost like a Harry Styles placement, but it's something, I don't like One Direction, so I'm not going to go down there. So I got that because basically I absolutely adore Death's Head Hawkmoth tattoos, like they are beautiful. And I am almost obsessed, I would say, with serial killers and stuff like that. So Silence of the Lambs is like one of my favourite films ever, and hang on. You can see all of like my killer boots, there's a severed Barbie head. Like I've got a whole collection of like serial killers, cannibals, stuff like that. So yeah, I have a bit of an obsession, so that was to represent like my love of like horror and serial killers and stuff like that. Okay, so that's all of my piercings and tattoos shown. As for future piercings and tattoos, I would really like more ear work done, but I'm kind of pussying out a bit, I suppose. And tattoos, I definitely want more tattoos. I have a few things in mind, but it's just a case of money. I do not have enough money for it at the moment, or ever in the near future, I think. So it might be a while until I get more tattoos. So yeah, if you have any questions about piercings or tattoos, just ask them down below and I'll answer them, and as always, like and subscribe. Bye!